Hi, everyone. Thanks for tuning in. I want to talk to you a little bit about expectations. So I've had the pleasure of talking with a number of you so far. I will get to everybody, so please be patient with me. But I have a message for you just between you and us here at the school as your partners in education of your child to make sure that we're really on the same page as far as expectations go. So first and foremost, folks, this is so challenging right now, and we're all figuring it out. And I really want you to be kind to yourself, give yourself a break, and understand that no matter what you do with your child, it's going to be okay. It's going to be good. And it's all fine. Back in March, when I first sent out our distance learning plan, before we knew that we were going to be closed for the full school year, we really wanted you to focus on those essential skills, reading, writing, math. And that really hasn't changed. Now, although that hasn't changed, we've also broadened things over the last week or two to include some other assignments and topics, because it's our job to provide the opportunity for your child to continue to move forward in all areas. However, we understand that you are not only parents, but you are working, you're trying to manage your own jobs, your own child, or other children, other people in your household. And you are, on top of that, you're like the rest of us, uncertain about the future and having a certain level of stress that can be kind of challenging, to say the least. So please be kind to yourself. Give yourself a break. And ultimately, you're in charge. It's your family. You have to make the best decisions possible for your child, for your family. And we understand that. We just ask that you communicate that with us. The children aren't great at sharing with us about how things are going. So please make sure that if you feel like your child needs a little, you know, kick in the butt to get things done, we can help with that, but we need to know. If it's something that, you know, you're telling your child, you know what, don't worry about that, you can just let that go, let us know so we can affirm you as well. Now, even though we're working on those essentials, we have all the other things that are happening as well. And again, those are opportunities for you. And I really want you to think about what is possible. And if you're finding you're too stressed, you can't sit with your child and work through those things, or whatever it might be, let it go. Just talk to us. There's a certain level of independence that the COA students have, that we have a higher expectation of them because they have the experience with Google Classroom that they've been working on. And frankly, they're just older and they can be more independent. Their level of independence and expectation is higher than Kauai or Ohia. So I apologize now for the Kauai, to the Kauai and Ohia families for the kind of the mix-up with the seesaw. So Miss Amanda and Mrs. Aceret did a really good job of setting up their seesaw. They have that all ready to go. And then I wanted to come in and add a second seesaw class that is the specials. And part of that had to do with there's a method in seesaw where you can actually allow students to see each other's work. It's a class setting. And we wanted to give students an opportunity to share and say, hey, you know what? I've been out there riding my skateboard every day for PE, and they have a video of themselves doing that. And that's cool. And we want other students to be able to see that kind of thing. So we set up these specials classes for that kind of opportunity. Seesaw is great for turning work in or sharing. And that's exactly the way we want to use that specials class. I will still be giving assignments through that specials class for art, but the PE, garden, hula, you won't have to turn anything in. However, the kids can share things if they want to, and that's great. So I apologize for you having to switch back and forth with those. Unfortunately, that's the only way really to make it work. for now. So, and again, if it's too much hassle and your child can't do it independently and you don't have the time to do it with them, don't worry, let it go. Now, Kumulea is going to start some hula classes on Friday. And I'm really glad to hear that. But again, your call. Her goal and my goal with her is to get the Keiki moving, share some love, make sure that they are getting a little education from Kumulea about our Hawaiian culture, and working towards a year-end celebration. So Kumulea will be doing those classes on Friday through Zoom. Nothing to turn in. All you have to do is have your child Zoom in and participate. I'll be sending the link out. They're 30-minute classes. Ohia will be at 10 a.m., Kauai will be at 11 a.m., and Koa will be at 1 p.m. So we hope that they can enjoy some time with Kumulea, maybe learn some hula, learn some songs, learn some chants, and have a little bit of fun with each other, too. I cannot emphasize enough that communication here is key. So if things are happening, please don't rely on your child to communicate. Please reach out to your child's teacher or me, and we'll work together to make this work. I really appreciate you. Thank you for all your hard work, and we will get through this together. All right. Thank you. Aloha.